Jó estét kívánok minden egyes és kedves tankos kollégának! Sziasztok! Hello! Hoztam nektek egy meglepetés vendéget Edgar személyében. Hi Edgar! Eddie, tonight in this half hour at least you're gonna hear a lot of how can I say? Interesting words. So please forget about it or don't mind it because this is our language, so I have to translate it and so on. It's going like that. Igen, Geri, 18-15. Ja, 18-15-öt írtam. Hát nem baj. Vannak hibák. Halljátok Edgárt? Amúgy. Azt légy szíves, mondjátok már vissza, mert beköszönt, és nem tudom, hogy hallatszik-e az ő hangja. Én nagyon remélem, hogy igen. Nem hallani Edgárt. A büdös. Nem úgy értem, hogy a fene egye meg. Okay, they don't hear you, so I'm gonna change the Discord. Just a moment. No, because from the iPad, I think it's not going. I mean, from the iPad, they just see the screen, but they don't hear anything. So, I have to change the Discord to PC. Just a moment.
Now okay. I don't hear you.
Eddie, do you hear me now?
Yeah, I hear you now.
Now I don't hear you, so I'm gonna... don't worry, I also have a solution for this. Na most lesz elvileg jó. Na, yeah. Okay, so now Eddie?
Yeah, I hear you, hello,
okay.
Hello.
I hear you too. Ultimate solution. Okay, and hopefully the guys. Most van. Most hallani? Okay, they said pacek. It means good.
Oh, nice.
Okay, do you see my live stream, Eddie? So
yeah,
I can start the video, right?
Sure.
Okay. Okay, srácok, szóval, mint tudjátok, Edgar ugye a Jones csapatát vezette harcba. Eddie, am I right? You were the field commander, right? Or not?
Yeah, I was the main strater and I was the commander with the help of Gaseo.
Okay. And this team... Let's just watch the first game, and until it's going, we can speak about the main things. So, if I can ask, this team, this Jones, how has it come to alive? I mean, if I see it well, there is a few Spanish guys in it, from your old Spanish clan. Oh, sorry, it's really cringe, but I don't remember the name. Sorry about it.
No, don't worry.
What is the clan name? I always forget it.
It was Terz.
Ah, Terz. Yes. Okay. Sorry, it's really cringe. Okay. So there's a few guys from the team, from Terz, right? Or not?
Okay. Yeah. So some years ago, we had I think all of the Spanish players that are here have been in Terz at some point. Mm-hmm. Some of them left earlier than me, and it was Rameo, Flanqueo, Gaseo, and me.
Mm-hmm.
It was four Spanish players in this
team. I see. And the rest of the guys, for example, Gosti, I remember he was Yeah, it's in his name. He started in Mach, and then, if I remember well, we will fight together in EZ, right? I mean,
yeah,
you,
that's it.
Ghosty, and me, Jako, Sevket, yeah, good old times. And Legoat, is Lewandowski ego or not?
Yeah, it's him, it's a French guy.
Okay, and there is Spiti left. Is he a new guy or?
He's new guy, yeah. He also
okay.
joined us.
For... New guy, free guy. Okay. Okay, so yeah. Some of my predictions, at least, was real. That's good for me. And really sorry about that. I forget your big Tesserrach. I don't know how
some
to
years
say
ago,
how to say
worry.
How to say Spanish.
We say tercios.
Tercios. Oh my god. Yeah. Casablanca. Okay. Okay. Well, now we are seeing the first game. It's I think on I think this battle doesn't go on like any of the team predicted. I mean, you don't want to do it like that, and they don't want to do it like this. Did you guys wanted to get the caps? I mean, did you guys want to get the cap advantage, or just going for C and try to dominate from there?
In this map, we like to play for map control.
Mm-hmm.
We believe the positions at the top of C is really strong, hard to get pushed, so we like to have some tanks there. And we also believe the positions on A are really good and can let us have some crossfires, even from A to C.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't play to have the caps at the beginning, but to
yeah,
get map control and be able to get the caps in the end.
Okay. So I'll... Edgar most itt azt mondja, hogy ugye ezen a pályának úgy szoktak játszani, hogy elvisznek egy bázist, ugye itt most ott például a C volt az, és akkor próbálják körbeállni a többi bázist úgy, hogy el tudjanak mozogni rá, és azonnal tudjanak reagálni bármiféle mozgásra. Illetve előtte pedig arról beszélgettünk, hogy ugye hogy állt össze a csapatuk, hogy jött össze ez a Jones nevezetű klán, és ugye, amit elmondtam nektek annó még a live-ba is, mikor az élőbe ment, úgy értem ez a csata, hogy egy csomó, vagy hát négy, rajta kívül három játékos jött a Tercios-ból, és van gyakorlatilag egy-két régi arc, akivel korábban együtt harcoltunk, ő is, én is, mint például Ghosty vagy Lewandowski, ugye Legoat jelen pillanatban, és van egy új srác, Spiti. Okay, and... Well, on this one, Loka win the first leg, so I think they were really aggressive, and they having a very good focus fire, at least in this battle, right?
To be honest, I didn't like how I remember this battle. I didn't like how they played. I think they were playing bad, and they knew it.
Mm-hmm.
And they just adapt to some playstyle that was kind of safe. I remember this round they were playing like really stuck with most of the heavies together.
Mm-hmm.
And they were really good at focusing fire and the team play, of course. But to be honest, their strats weren't the best and there was always a way to outplay them. The problem about this game is that I got overconfident that no one got spotted. And
uh-huh.
I tried my luck on the A base. And then we lost one tank for free there. And I think that made the difference. But If I could get into A from the other side and just play it safe and get the info, that game would have been for us, like at the next game, because
mm-hmm.
we played the same strat mirrored.
I see. Yes, on this level, when you lose one tank earlier, or, I mean, the most of the HP of one tank, it can be decide the whole game. If it's not going well, or if it's even not going the way you planned it, so yeah, I can feel it. Yeah, it's really annoying. Okay, szóval igazából azt mondtam most Edgar, hogy itt ugye ezen a pályán, meg úgy amúgy is ebben az elődöntőben a Loka így a biztonságra játszott leginkább, és nem is biztos, hogy ez az ő legjobb játékstílusuk, mert hogy ugye nekik van a egyik, vagy ha nem a legjobb, Edgar azt mondta, hogy a legjobb stratégiájuk, ugye a Foxy, I mean, this was the old name of the guy, right? who makes the struts on Loka. Am I right, Eddie?
Yeah, his name is Foxy. Yeah.
And the actual name of him? Do you know that or not?
I forgot it. I knew it, but I forgot it.
Oh, okay, we will see it on the on the screen anyway soon, and you will tell us. Okay, szóval erről beszélgettünk, ugye, hogy, hogy az ő stratégiájuk az egyik legjobb, és hogy a komfortzónájukon picit kívül, de elég egyszerűen játszottak, tehát együtt a heavy-kkel fókuszáltak, és Edgarék pedig nem tudtak időbe spottolni, nem látták a mozgásokat, emiatt igazából itt jó. Csapatjátékban legyőzték őket, úgy értem, hogy csapatjátékban, hogy egy helyen többen voltak, és nagyobb fókusz lőttek, mint a Johnny. Oké, okay. Let's see the next game. And I got surprised about that you guys played like one map on one of the sites, and then next round. I mean, next round is a different map and also just one game on it. I think it's not too fair. Am I right? Or what do you think, Eddie?
Oh, actually, yes. It was because this was the pick and ban system.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you know how it works.
Yeah, I remember because when we were in Seattle, we do the same. Yeah.
So basically, okay. The team picking the map was not picking the spawn.
Yes. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, that's tricky.
Yeah.
Okay. Aha, szóval azért voltak így a pályák, srácok, mert ugye itt már előre ki lehetett választani, hogy vagy hát pályákból ki lehetett választani, hogy melyikre mész, és viszont azt nem választottad ki, hogy melyik oldalra. Tehát ugye azért vannak elég aszimmetrikus pályák, úgyhogy ez elég érdekes volt, tehát te választottad ki a mapot, akkor az ellenfél választotta ki az oldalt, úgyhogy olyan pályákat volt érdemes választani, ahol mind a két oldalon jól játszottál. And this battle was very good. I mean, I really enjoyed to even watch this. You guys go down and just focus this fantastic guy and then you guys were really fast on the A. I mean, I was like, you guys gonna lose because there is three tank for you, only three, and there is not enough cover for them, and they have five tank in front of you. But you guys flank it really fast on the A, and the Johnny guys did a very good focus, I think. How did you feel see this battle?
So this battle is actually a second part because we had a match on canal in the same spawns, and we were playing a grill. And our grill was useless. He dropped to the ditch and died for free. And we said, we have played this strat for really long. We know how to play on this map. Mm-hmm. Like, it's one of our best maps. We are absolutely sure on how to play this map. Mm-hmm. So we will just drop the grill and play one more heavy to make sure we take control of the A and B area fast.
Mm-hmm.
And we always use the two beakers, the double beakers, to go to the corner. And because it's the fastest tank that can go there without getting spotted. Only an IS-7 dropping to the middle can spot it. And if they drop with IS-7 to spot our beakers, then we kill the IS-7s with our heavy. So it's
nice.
Really, so it's kind of a really mature strat by us. And we were so sure about what to do when we saw the IS-7 advance. We were saying, like, let's take our five heavies and push forward almost.
I really enjoyed this match, really. It was awesome. Oké, okay, szóval Edgar azt mondta, hogy igen, tehát ez volt gyakorlatilag a stratégiájuk, ugye, hogy a vikerszekkel fölmennek az A-ra, azt ugye semmi nem tudja spotolni, max egy ilyesét, ami ledroppol ide az árokba, de ugye az árokba pedig ők is beraktak három hevit, és azzal lenyomták azt az ilyesetet, és gyakorlatilag ugye beszorították őket a bázisukra, és így nyertek. That was a really good battle, Eddie. I mean, I just can't get enough from it. I extremely enjoyed it. It was so much joy to see. Oh. So it's 1-1 now, and we are gonna go to the third map, which I don't remember. Sorry, yes, Eddie.
I like to see the faces of my teammates over there.
Yeah, I don't really like it at all, but sometimes it was good. Sometimes it was good. Wargaming shouldn't have to put all the faces after all the battles on the live screen, I think. But it was really good sometimes. I don't know how you saw it, but in my opinion, it's like that.
I mean, as long as they don't show your faces when you lose, I think it was fine.
Okay. Azt mondtam Andinek, hogy szerintem nem volt olyan jó, hogy minden csata után beadták az arcokat, mert hogy nem mindig adta vissza az érzést, vagy hogy nekem annyira nem volt szimpi, mert egyszerűen úgy feleslegesnek, túlzásnak tartottam. Jó, meg csak annyit mondott, hogy hát, hogyha vesztünk, és akkor mutatják, az nyilván nem jó. Aj, megint beletekerek. Oh. Sorry, I just... Yes. Okay, now it should be fine. So it should be the third leg. It should be 1-1, and... what is this best map? Alpenstadt. Yes, Alpenstadt, and it's 1-1. Am I right?
Yeah, it's Alpenstadt and it's 1-1.
Should be. Put it on the screen. Miért nem rakják ki? No, it's 1-2. Why? It should be 1-1 because we only saw... Ah, okay.
It's 1-1, right? When we get here?
Yeah. Now, Rockfield. Rockfield, sorry. Yeah, so this is the third leg. Rockfield. Ez a harmadik csata. Rockfield. And there is a lot of 60 TPs, right? So it's... Loka used way more 60 TPs in those part of the game. I mean, in those part of the final. Maybe it was because also what you said, that they played for the safety, right?
Yeah, as I said, probably Loka is probably the best team in terms of team play in EU right now,
mm-hmm.
and they make use of it. Maybe they don't have the skillest, the most skilled players, but of course they are skilled. But their team play is absolutely amazing, and they make use of the meta tank that has the consumable that can put on like some shots of 700 HP, and with that they know how to play. They trained a lot. And they feel comfortable with. And, uh-huh. you know, I think they were not feeling really comfortable on the strats they prepared. So they just played together with one or two tanks disconnected from the rest of the team, but in Wolfpack. And that was working for them.
Yes. Eddie most annyit mondott igazából, hogy ugye, amit már beszéltünk, hogy ugye a 60 TP-k ilyenkor, hogyha együtt játszik a csapat, és tényleg nem nagyon mozdul el játékos a csapatnak a fő tengelyétől, vagy fő pontjától, azt a Loka nagyon jól ki tudja használni. Tehát, hogy ők talán nem biztos, hogy egytől eddig a legjobb játékosok, de viszont csapatban szuper ügyesek, és nagyon-nagyon talán a legjobban tudnak együtt játszani. És azért játszanak így, ilyen formán, ilyen tankokkal, ezzel sokat gyakoroltak, ugye magabiztosnak érzik velük magukat, és ezért jelennek meg ilyen formán. És hát igazuk is van, ők ebben erősek, ezt kell játszaniuk. Ugye Edgarék pedig szerintem inkább szeretnek úgy játszani, hogy mindig kitalálnak valami extrát. Edgar, remember, you always having some ideas, some extra ideas, I mean, for the strategies. And that's what I see on the strategies of the Johnnies. So I really liked it. And I'm right. Yes? Am I right about this?
Yeah. I like to try like original stuff. But of course, I don't want to try something that I think it will not work. Like sometimes people say, okay, this is meta, but doesn't really need to be like you are not forced to use those tanks to win. In my opinion, there's not like, okay, you can only use 60 TP to win. That's not true. You can combine different tanks. You just need to understand what you're doing.
Yes. And now they are pushing on exactly you, actually. Yeah, unfortunately. Yeah, I think yes, and I remember you guys gonna lose this match because they pushed too fast, or you guys just don't expect that many players in the same place.
Basically, what I'm watching, I think Speedy threw a bit. He almost died for free.
Mm-hmm.
And then I didn't like what guys on C did. I wanted the heavies to be more together and just keep the beakers spotting around there and maximum one heavy. But mm-hmm. our heavy, which was Lego, I wanted him to be at the top of C so that he can put some shots, cross shots,
yes.
into A. But yeah, we got caught out of position on this push. And probably we should have been a bit more back on A. But the problem is that if we went back on A, they also had the points. So I don't know. I think we could have done something else, or probably try to stop B and take control of B and C and stay really defensive on A, maybe. Either that or just... But losing Speedy for free really made the difference that we didn't even stand a chance on this game.
Yeah, so there was some kind of misunderstanding, if I get it well.
Yeah, it was misunderstanding.
Okay. Szóval igazából ez a csata a Johnnynek ugye azon ment el, hogy egyrészt nem nagyon értették meg egymást, tehát volt egy játékos, Spiti, aki gyakorlatilag ingyen halt meg, tehát hogy ugye nem nagyon sebzett, és őt meg gyorsan kikapták, mert olyan pozícióban volt, ahol mindenhonnan ráláttak sajnos, aztán pedig ugye le tudták pusholni Edgárt, és onnantól gyakorlatilag -2-ben voltak. Nem értették meg annyira egymást a Johnnyk, és így alakult ki ez a 1-2-es állás. Yes, okay, so it wasn't a good game for you guys, but here comes Alpenstadt, where, ooh. Oh, I like the mouse on this map, actually, and oh, E50M, okay, very good lineup, with 360 TPs, and there is a lot of heavies in front of you, with MVOs and with the Vickers. And both of the teams go for the A, but there was two... Of course, there was two tanks on B from you guys, because the mouse and one for the cap. I like these caps, when you put the mouse in front and there is just a free cap behind it.
yeah, dude, that's the point.
Now, Loka seems like really want to get and defend A with the Yo tanks, and they don't focus on B or even C.
Yeah, that's true. On this map, we like to, like, it is not possible to outplay them on A because the cross shots at the beginning, the north spawn is better.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do is just hold it and then do something on B. But we hold it in such a way that it's impossible for them to push us, so we can take more control of the map from B and even crossfire their guys from... Because for me, there are some nice crossfires and also the points. So yeah. We just make the move there. We know we have an advantage.
Mm-hmm.
And they are kind of stuck there, so we make the first move and we wait to see what they do.
Yes, yeah, this is the point. This is the point when I really didn't ever not understand Loka, that why you can see, I stop it, there is five tanks on the same spot, spot. It's really easy to get them stuck, to circle them, to shoot them from any place. You even can see it from the minimap.
Yeah, that's the thing, that's what I said on this game against us, after they lost. They changed their playstyle. I think they were not confident and they just trust on their team play and play together. But if you know how to counter that, there's nothing they can do. Of course, a minimal mistake can make you lose still. But as I said, it was a great opportunity for us to get through the final. And I think we wasted it. We were so close.
Yes, I saw it in this way too. Szóval most igazából arról beszélgettünk Edivel, hogy ugye ők azért mentek a B-re, mert onnan könnyebb map kontrollt kialakítani, ugye irányítani a pályán lévő történéseket, és teljesen igaza van benne, mert ugye az A-t azt rengeteg helyről lehet lőni, vagy hát oda lehet érni azért. Ugye a Loka erre koncentrált, és innen akart kijönni, de mire innen ki akartak jönni, gyakorlatilag körbevették az egész, nézzétek meg, egy C betűt írnak le a pirosak, ugye a dzsanisok a loka körül kis túlzással, és öt tankjuk ide beragadt egy helyre, amivel nem is tudnak mit kezdeni. And yeah, they just get more stuck. Oh, look at this.
They played bad on this round, to be honest.
Yes.
Loka is not this bad. I mean, Loka are really good. Like, Loka were having bad day. Maybe
yeah,
they were tired or out of ideas, but they are much better than how they played against us.
Yeah, I was surprised. I mean, to be honest, I didn't watch you guys. I mean, I didn't know the level of your team, the strongness of your team. So I was really surprised and also happy, of course, to see this battle. But yeah, also surprised about Loka because they just doing your stupid things. Maybe they just get too excited or I don't know. Sorry, Eddie, I didn't hear it.
Look how they are just moving like sheep, you know? They are just going back all together. It's
yes.
It was fun, man, how this game went.
Igen, szóval, hogy gyakorlatilag ezt beszéltünk már még egyszer, hogy itt a Loka elég rosszul mozgott, és valószínűleg itt komfortzónájukon kívül kerültek, azért alakulhatott úgy az a meccs, ahogy. By the way, they have still more HP, which I don't understand, but they're gonna lose this round for sure.
I think it's because we have one med and one light, like the Vickers and the A50M.
Mm-hmm. Ah, yeah. Yeah, most likely. Yeah, because
they focused the mouse, so it was a good plan for us. We let our mouse die and then
yes,
we get the advantage.
Focusing the mouse is not the best thing what you can do.
Yeah, but you realize that even if they were playing bad, they made some move altogether, focused our tanks, and as you said, the HP difference was not that big. So
yeah,
even if in this meta or in this game and all on competitive, the strats are like a minor percentage that can make you win. The biggest thing for me is the team play. Of course, the strats can make the difference in this situation, but if you don't have team play, it doesn't matter which strat you play. That
well, yeah, the good strategy can give you I don't know, an advantage, a kind of advantage, if it's going well, of course. But then after it, it's always depend on the players, on the team play, and on the strongness of the team, I think.
Yeah, I agree on that.
Igen, szóval, hogy most itt a Johnny-k szépen kiegyenlítettek, és ugye igazából amiről beszéltünk, az volt, hogy a legfontosabb a csapatjáték, jó stratégiák tudnak előnyt adni, de igazából a csapatjátékon múlik minden, tehát hogy mennyire tud egy csapat jól együtt dolgozni, olyan dolgokat látni előre, vagy mozgásokat megcsinálni előre, amiket nem is kell kérni mondjuk ugye a field commandernek, tehát aki vezeti a csapatot. És mit is mondott még Edi, hogy mindjárt kinyögöm, hogy igen, hogy ugye a Loka hiába volt egy rossz stratégiájuk, vagy rosszul alakult nekik meccs közbe a sztori, tehát ugye láttatok, egy helyen beszorultak öten, az a lehető legrosszabb, amikor így körbevesznek és beszorultak egy helyre, még ebből is ki tudtak hozni egy egész kis arányú vereséget, tehát gondolok itt főleg az életerőre. Úgyhogy ez az, ami igazán megmutatja a Lokának az erejét, hogy mennyire jól tudnak csapatba játszani, hogyha tényleg csak nyers csapatjátékról van szó, szóval elképesztő. And the next map going to be Canal.
Vineyards.
Vineyards, sorry. Yes, I wanted to say Vineyards. Vineyards. This map is Maricon.
Yeah. I agree on.
And
we didn't pick it. It was Loka picking it.
Mm-hmm. But I think you guys get the better spawn. Or not? One of the spawn is
actually,
always stronger.
Actually, yes. Actually, yes, but we didn't pick it. Oh, wait, actually? Did we? No. Yeah, we did pick it, I think. We did pick it. I mean, Loca chose Vineyards, and we chose the South Spawn.
Yeah. I mean, it's a stupid thing to pick Vineyards, because if you pick Vineyards, the enemy going to choose the South Spawn, where is the advantage?
Yeah. Maybe they expected that, and they thought they would make some kind of counter, but to be honest, we prepared for this. We knew there was Vineyards. We didn't want to pick it, so what we did is just prepare strat from South Spawn, and we did it. Mm-hmm. And we were so happy when they picked Vineyards, I was like, okay, this is interesting.
Okay, so there was also a strategy for picking the maps.
Yeah, of course, we prepared for that because we had time to do it.
Really nice. Okay. Well, yeah, right. You guys having like a half an hour or something like that. Am I right? Or not? Or more?
Yeah, but the thing is that we knew the map pool, and we did it even the day before without knowing the map. We did it without knowing the map. Oh, we wanted to make sure we had OP strats on all maps.
Okay. And this kind of moves, I mean, why they did this? They just gone through under the bridge, like, with four tanks. Why?
I really... You know what are my thoughts on what happened this game?
Sorry?
I think that the problem here was that their commander was playing a Vickers, and he was spotting at the middle. And as soon as I saw the Vickers spotting at the middle, I thought, okay, let's go with the IS-7 and pressure him, make him run. And when Fox is on pressure, he cannot call properly. So, I don't know, probably he made a wrong decision. He was under pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, when you get tanks in the middle on Vineyards, like, there can be easily a push. It's a map where you can just go forward with all tanks and push, and
yes,
if you have Vickers there and we have IS-7, which is fast heavy, it's not that easy to run away with the Vickers. And I think after the stress, he didn't know what to do, and he just said, okay, I like push the IS-7s. But of course, it was a bad decision.
Yeah, it's absolutely. I mean, I agree. I didn't understand the whole thing here. Okay, so I'll... Ugye erről beszélgettünk, hogy itt mindig az elkezdtem, hogy erről beszélgettünk. Tehát a lényeg, hogy a Loka választotta a pályát, Vineyards-ot, viszont ugye az ellenfél, ilyen esetben ugye a Johnnyk, Edgarék választották a spawnt. Tehát onnantól kezdve, hogy ők választották a spawnt, tudták az előnyösebb spawnt választani, ami értelemszerűen a déli rész volt, és igazából ők csak felvették a pozíciókat, ugye előnybe kerültek pontokba is ráadásul, és csak vártak a Loka megmozdulására, ami egy tök rossz döntés volt, mint kiderült. Ugye itt a híd alatt nem szokás pusolni. Nem is jött be. Nagyon tömören ennyi, de igazából ugye Eddie is azt mondta, hogy gyakorlatilag ez egy olyan pálya, ahol bármerre lehet pusolni, vagy tényleg... nyomni egy jolót több tankkal, és meg lehet nyerni vele a csatát, de itt valószínűleg arról lehetett szó, hogy ugye a Vickers nem látta, aki valószínűleg az FC volt, tehát aki irányította a srácokat, hogy pontosan hol vannak az ellenfelek, vagy hogy pontosan hol lenne érdemes pusolni, és egyszerűen egy rossz döntést hozott. Okay, and this battle is just decided here, I think, because you guys focused all of them, and that's it.
Yeah, they vanished.
Okay, I think we can just go for the next one. The next one is
Yukon.
Yukon.
Okay. I'm not sure if I want to watch Yukon game after it was so close, man. It was like our ticket to the finals.
Yeah, because it was 3-2 for you guys. And well, yeah, almost all of the guys from Loka were on B and close to A. And you guys have in five tanks on A, and two in the back, or only one? Only one in the back. The you guys have in a Vickers or not? No, an IS-7, I guess.
Yeah, an IS-7.
It was for spot or?
It was just to cover the flank,
mm-hmm.
in case someone tried to come there, and just to be able to make some move in the end, because you don't need to go with seven tanks to same position, so you just keep it at the back and decide
yes.
what to do later.
Oké, okay. Szóval azért volt ott az ilyesét nekik, hogy ugye tudjon spotolni, ha esetleg arra jön valaki, meg amúgy se kell ugye nyilván a hét tank ugyanabba a pozícióba, pláne egy ilyen pályán, hogy gyakorlatilag az ott a taktikai ilyesét volt. And now we can see the IS-7 making a move in the way of C, if I'm not mistaken, yes. Daneo going to C.
Our IS-7, yeah.
And now, yeah, yes, I remember now. I was thinking that you guys really gonna win this one because you were pushing on the under C and between A and C as well. And this push was really good in my opinion. But yeah, it's
I
just
the problem was Timo move. Do you see this? I think this move was what made us lose. Timo move was unnecessary in my opinion. Also, he just did one shot and then died. I don't
mm-hmm.
know why.
Yes, maybe he was too early. He was easy to get focused. Because he was alone, I mean, not alone, but a bit far from
then
the
also, I missed one shot because I didn't. I wanted to try the AP. If I use a hit, it was full pen.
Mm-hmm.
And even if it was only one shot, to be honest, I think it could have been the difference.
Yeah, it was a really close game. I don't remember exactly the HP difference, but I remember it was really close. Igen, szóval Eddie arról beszélt, hogy nagyon sajnálja ezt a csatát, mert gyakorlatilag ez egy jegy volt nekik a döntőbe, és nagyon apró dolgokon ment el, mondta, hogy ő is elrontott sajnos egy lövést, meg hogy a Timeo ugye a 60 TP-vel talán túl hamar ment be, és túlságosan egyedül, tehát hogy könnyű volt fókuszálni. Ugye az, hogy egyedül mész be valahova nem feltétlenül jelenti azt, hogy valójában egyedül lépsz be oda, vagy legalábbis blitzes nyelven, hanem azt, hogy egy kicsit távolabb a többiektől, tehát akár, mit tudom én, 5-6 méterrel előrébb, hogyha ilyen közelharci jellegű csatákról van szó, akkor az sokat számít, mert akkor könnyű téged fókuszálni, tehát ugye kilógsz a sorból, akár az autóim nem kavarodik meg rajtad, tehát egyszerűen akkor könnyű fókusz lőni. What was the HP difference?
I think we had at least 2k advantage, maybe.
Yes.
Or one, something like that. Also, the problem, I think, rather than Timo pushing there, it's he doing alone, because I think they went with two heavies from the left,
mm-hmm.
from outside, and it wasn't needed. Daniel was enough to get the flank. If we
mm-hmm.
had two heavies together with Timo, they could share HP, and we would have won, in my opinion. If you go back to the where we start the push, I think we can see two tanks advancing on the outside, probably. I don't know where. Yeah, I think there were two tanks advancing through the outside. I think maybe it was Lego and Daniel, and this is why Timo died so fast. So it was not only Timo's fault, but it was like
a bit fault. He was a bit early. That's what I'm telling the guys, that even 5, 6, or 10 meters can make the difference, because it's easy to focus you if you're a bit ahead.
Yeah.
We will see now. Timo is going there. Going. He got one, but he's gonna get some help from the left, yes, from Lego and Daneo. Oof, but oh, Timo got a lot from there. I mean, I don't know from where. Maybe from now. From the 60 TP and from the IS-7. Yes. Well,
also, Lego went from outside and he should have gone with Timo. If Lego goes with Timo, it's a win for us. But look, Lego and Daniel, full HP, wasting time when they already killed Timo before. Like, yeah, as you say, 10 seconds before.
Yes, Timo didn't get any shield from the guys, and he was easy to focus, and he stuck in that corner. Unfortunately, it was a good move, a really good move from Loka, but yeah. Well, yeah, shit happens.
Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate.
Yes, if you can make a battle where you don't lose any tanks for free like that, it's all on your hands. I mean, you can win against anybody if you're yeah. doing good on the HP. And the last game is
Port Gay.
Port Gay, yes.
Port Boozy.
You know what map I like too? Black Godwill. You know the name?
Yeah.
Black cock wheel. Don't worry, it's not for kids, so it's okay. I mean, it should be okay. YouTube gonna tell us in a few hours, I guess. Okay, so this one, you guys take A, going on a B to deep, or maybe not too deep, I don't know, but close to B, and Loka takes C, and now it's 3-3. What was the plan from you guys?
The plan was keep on one heavy isolated on A, on cooldown position on their spawn, so you spot, and if they try to push you, you have cover from the other flank, mm-hmm. and then keep the rest of the heavies together, but on smart positions. Mm-hmm. And that is what went wrong. The smart positions part was not fulfilled.
Okay.
Especially our yours. Especially our yours. You know, there is a little building between spawn 2 and where our guys are right now. Or like a few seconds.
I'm going to start it because, yeah, we don't see it. Yeah, now we see it.
There is like a building a bit behind, like close to the spawn, where you can stay safe there with the yours.
Yes.
Our yours should have been there. So this way, when they try to advance from outside, they have the clip, they can hide, but you just need to see how our yours died when they started pushing. And that is the only reason why we lost. The main reason in this game.
Yeah, because actually the old tanks got wasted, basically. Because they just, most likely, if I guess it well, they have to stay unspotted, right? Because if they are C2 or maybe only one IS-7 there, they're going to push it. But when you have yours behind, it's not the best for the enemy.
yeah, that's true.
It was the plan, right? Or something like this.
Yeah, it was the plan, yeah, to bait them to push us, to have always the five heavies together.
Okay, see. Szóval Eddie azt mondja, hogy gyakorlatilag az A bázist, ugye ezt a déli, a dokkos részt akarták elvinni, egy ilyesetet oda beküldtek előre, hogy tudjon spotolni, lássa, hogy mi történik azon az oldalon, hogyha ott van valami. A többiek felveszik a pozíciókat a városba, ugye nyilván védekezően, okosan, ügyesen, és ugye itt a jó tankok talán túl előre mentek, őket el kellett volna rejteniük, gyakorlatilag egyből itt, ahova most megy vissza a Lego, az épületek mögött itt a spawn mellett, itt jobbra, most a Lego attól jobbra. Oda kellett volna elbújniuk, hogy megnyomják ezeket az ilyeseteket, és akkor ők kibújnak, és le tudnak tárazni valakit. Ez maradt el. Egy admin, légy szíves, bannolná Laughface XYZ-t. Köszönöm szépen. Nem is értem. Okay, and now we are still... Yeah, it's not decided yet. Nothing happening right now, but unfortunately they spotted the Yos, so they know where the O-Tanks is. Which is a problem, if I get it well.
Yeah, because it's the DPM tanks. If they kill them, they win the game. And the armor of the Yo is really weak when it comes to a brawl. As long as you're not cooled down, Yo is paper tank, easy to pen, so... Easy
yeah,
to focus.
The track can be tricky sometimes, but not on this level. And now the Mouse take the B, and they are pushing outside C to your spawn.
Uh-huh.
But I don't remember now how it's get escalated because, yeah, okay, and now this three tank, yeah, and they always getting too much, way too much, and only put two shots in, if I see it well.
And that position, he should be on the on the building, yes. That is like.
Oh yes, which was on the right when he died.
You know, you see 260 DPS being able to put the shots there, and Lego threw this game, in my opinion. Like, that was really bad.
Yes, or maybe he got tired or something, but yeah, it was bad positioning, that's for sure.
So yeah, we lost the first gun so easily.
And look at the HP now, on the Loka tanks. They are shared the HP really well. Five tanks on low HP, but they are still alive. Am I right? I mean, this is a very good team effort or team skill when you can share the HP, and you can stay on the same HP. I mean, low level of HP, but still alive. It's really a few teams just which can do it.
So when you play with some heavy tanks with good armor, like 60 DPS or IS-7s, and you play together,
mm-hmm.
It favors the team play. Of course, as I said, sometimes it's not the best when it comes to strat. But even if our strat was better, as I said, one minor mistake kicks you out from the game. And we had mistake, we lose the Yoss, and we lose the game. So
yes,
game over. It was like that.
Yeah. It's like when the old times, if you remember, the grill was a meta, and if the enemy did a counter for the grill, or maybe for true, if you had two grill, and they mm-hmm. did a counter for it or something, and they just take it out from the game, it's completely changed it, and they got the advantage. It's like that with the Yoss here right now, I think.
Yeah, it is.
And yeah, unfortunately, it's soon coming to an end because they did a good focus, killing the Yoss, and make you guys a bit stuck on the spawn. A bit, not too much, but a bit, but enough, unfortunately, for a defeat.
Yeah, absolutely.
Szóval igen, itt ugye az történt, hogy a jó tankokat gyakorlatilag rosszul pozícionálták Edgarék, és emiatt sajnos nem tudták kihasználni a bennük rejlő előnyt, ugye a DPM-et, a tárat, és emiatt ugye már -2-be kerültek, ugye ott be is kerítették őket a bázison, a maradék tankokat, és gyakorlatilag abból már akkor előnyt kovácsoltak, amit nem lehetett visszahozni. Okay, Eddie. It's been a pleasure for me, and I know you have a training already, so I don't want to steal your time. So you can go if you want. I mean, if you have to go.
Unfortunately, they are ready, and we have like training with a new roster after the merge with the top BPS player. So the first training, I really want to
yes,
see how.
Yes, of course. It will be. Eddie, don't joke with me. It's more important, way more important than a live stream with me. We can do it anytime. And yeah, you guys have really good new players. Object, and who?
Object, F, General, and Whoopsie.
Oh, Jenny.
Yeah, Jindra.
Jindra. Okay. That's going to be a really strong team. Okay, Eddie. Well, thank you for your time, really. I really appreciate it. It was a pleasure
thank
for
you
me.
It was fun.
It's always always good to hear you. And I think the Hungarian guys also really liked it and got some pro stuff from you, really. So thank you a lot. Hopefully we can do something in the future together more like this, but we will see.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, Eddie, thank you, and have a good training with the new guys.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Goodbye.
No, srácok, hát nagyon gyorsan, tömören, ez volt a melyiket kell kivennem a fülemből, azt hiszem ezt, igaz? Aha, ezt. Szóval nagyon gyorsan, tömören, ez volt a Loka és a Johnnyknak a találkozója. Ezt most már átrakom. Sajnos, ugye most így kérdésekre, meg mi egymásra nem nagyon volt idő, mert Edgar rohant, így is kicsit feltartottam, úgyhogy örülök már, hogy itt tudott lenni egyáltalán, meg hogy végre össze tudtuk hozni, mert már egy ideje terveztük, de mindig vagy neki, vagy nekem nem volt jó. Én most igazából, hogyha nincsen úgy nagyon kérdésetek, és úgy látom, hogy most nem igazán vagyon, akkor nem is húznám nagyon tovább az időt, mert ugye nyilván van karácsonyi event, meg mi egymás, de arról majd külön live-ot szeretnék csinálni, arról külön szeretnék beszélni nektek, nem pedig csak most így meglengetni előttetek. Belépek a játékba, de most arról nem nagyon szeretnék úgy beszélni. Most már régóta akartam nektek csinálni egy ilyen nem szponzorált tartalmat, mert ezzel meg hát több ilyennel is nagyon sok ilyen adós vagyok felétek. Úgyhogy legalább most egy sikerült, ami szerintem egy tök érdekes tartalom volt. És aztán utána jönnek a karácsonyi sztorik. Abban lesz szponzorált sztori is. Lehet giftelni friendeknek, majd megpróbáljuk. Lehet húzni a Battle Pass-t, ott a hógolyó, már tizet, tizetebből kibontottam, de semmit nem dobott, úgyhogy kíváncsi vagyok, hogy lesz a többi. Aukció is van, goldos ládák is vannak, minden van, gyerekek. Mindenképpen Maxi mindjárt nyomok neked egy 18K-s csomagot, de olyat! Na jó van. Jó van, srácok, úgyhogy ha nem veszitek véresen magatokra, akkor igazából én most így együtt terveztem, és akkor mondom a karácsonyja, meg mi egymással. Jövök, és remélhetőleg minél előbb. Szerintem 25-éig nem, 26-án valószínűleg, mert akkor lesz olyan, hogy szabad időnevezetű történet. Igen, addig nem. És úgy tényleg köszönöm nektek, hogy itt voltatok, hogy megnéztetek ezt a kis rendhagyó live-ot Edgarral. Szerintem nagyon klassz volt, én nagyon élveztem, próbáltam fordítani mindent. Remélem, hogy aki nem értette az angolos részét, az így általában nagyjából megértette és átlátta. GIF tutorial az. És találkozunk legközelebb. Megint jön a love face, nem igaz már. Na jó, srácok, köszönöm szépen. Legyen szép estétek, sziasztok, ciao.